Ladies and gentlemen, it is a pleasure and a privilege to say a few concluding words at this conference. But first, I want to strike a somber note, because on the 7th of November this year, there will be 100 years since the Bolshevik Revolution was made, and totalitarian communism cost the lives of 100 million people. And we should never forget those people, and I think some scholarship at least, for example, the writing of history, is about trying to give voice to the victims, trying to make all those invisible people who are lying in their graves and the silent, trying to give them some voice. So let us remember all the victims of totalitarianism in the 20th century, and let us realize that communism was just as totalitarianism and as a national socialism was. Well, we can all course well upon history, as we have done to some extent here, and we can learn a lot from history and also from politics. Sometimes we have to take the option, which has been discussed here, about the least worse, and I believe that democracy is the least worse of all the possible forms of government. And also I think that we have to participate in politics. It's not mutually exclusive to believe in ideals and also to try to defend our freedom in the political arena. So I would strongly advocate trying also in politics to opt for the least worse there. But then young people, as Hayek said in the essay which has been referred to here, the intellectuals and socialism, he also said that we can't only think in terms of strategy on least worse options. We also have to have ideals and dreams and even the courage to think of a liberal utopia, and that has also been done here today. And I think that's the task of liberal scholarship, to extend our ideas of what is politically possible. Or in other words, to make the invisible hand visible, to explain that we can solve most, perhaps all of our problems by coordination without commands, by free transaction of independent intellectuals. So I think that classical liberalism opens up a fascinating research program of freedom without coercion. And since we are going to enjoy discussions at the invitation of Gamma tonight, I'm not going to say anything more except for one thing, one observation. When we think about both the totalitarian menace that loomed over the whole of the 20th century and all the hopes and dreams that have come true in many ways, and of which we are going to celebrate in October our institute with publishing the book Progress, by Johan Norberg, and he is coming to Iceland on the 23rd of October to discuss his book and all the hope that one can see besides the misery. But let us remember that freedom is a fragile flower that we have to keep up and we have to guard. We don't really have to fight for it, and we don't have to water it, at not least in blood, but in arguments. Thank you very much.